Okay, this is for field permeability test, which is pumping well test. Alright, so what we want to identify from this video is to get the coefficients of permeability from the unconfined aquifer pumping test and juga confined aquifer pumping test. Alright, so this is how the schematic diagram of the pumping test. So there are two types of pumping test. The first one here is for the confined aquifer. Okay, so for the confined aquifer, alright, so this is the setting up of the apparatus at the field site. Alright, so if you can see here that we have the pumping well, so we have the pumping well and also two observation well. Alright, so we have two observation well. Alright, now, so for the confined aquifer, you will notice that the aquifer layer, when we are talking about the aquifer layer, it's actually referring to the permeable layer. Okay, strata here means layer, permeable strata, permeable layer means that whether it's sands or gravel, soil types. So when it's confined, that the aquifer layer will be covered by another layer of impermeable here. So impermeable is normally referred to the clay and silts. Okay, it's always referred to the clay and silt. Alright. Okay, so now we need to know all the parameter here, that we have H0 here, H1 and H2 and also D. Okay, D is the thickness of the second layer or the thickness of the aquifer layer. And we have the distance from the pumping point to the observation well, center to center, and also R2 is from the observation well too. So when you want to sketch the diagram, so make sure that you sketch correctly for whether it confined or unconfined. So be very careful. For the confined, the top layer is basically by the impermeable layer, then the second layer will be followed by the aquifer layer. So this is the derivations of the equation for the aquifer, a confined aquifer. So again, we will use the Darcy's law, and the area here will the area through which the flow will take place is at the aquifer layer, which is you have the 2 pi rd, that d is the thickness of the aquifer layer. So as you can see here, the arrangement, the rearrangement and the integrations of the equation, yeah, where at the end of the day you will have this equation where q ln r2 r1 divided by 2 pi d h2 minus h1. So what is h2 and h1? You can refer to the diagram here. And what is the d? D is the thickness of the aquifer layer, and q is the pumping rate or the quantity of water that pumping out. So this is an example. You can see the question here, and this is the solutions of the example. So as you can see here, that the pumping well sunk into a 11.7 meter sand. And here it states that the sand layer is overlain by the clay layer, meaning that above the sand layer you have the clay layer. So this is confined aquifer. Alright, so be very careful. Also mentioned here is the piezometric level. Piezometric level, also known as a groundwater tables. Okay, so it's referred to the same definitions. Okay, piezometric level is where is the groundwater table located below the ground surface. You have the D1 and D2 here. It is the drawdown when you're pumping out of water, that the flow lines of the drawdown can be seen through the observation layer. So the reading will be recorded at the observation layer D1 and D2. So how to get the H0 here is H0. Okay, be very careful that H0 must always from the groundwater table. It's not from the top or the ground surface. Okay, the H0 must be from the groundwater table. This is the common mistake when you use that H0 is from the top or the ground surface. It actually is the thickness or the height of the from the ground water table to the end of the aquifer layer. That is the H naught. So once you have the D1, you can calculate the H1, and also given the D2, you can calculate the H2. Remember that also the gaps or the thickness of D1 and D2, the reading of D1 and D2 ni is from the groundwater table. The drawdown will be from the groundwater table where is water exists. Alright, above the groundwater table there is no water, so there is no drawdown developed. Alright, so be very careful with this. Alright, so once you have all the parameter, so you can simply use this equation with the thickness of the aquifer layer is 11.7. So this is the answer for the confined aquifer from the example. For the unconfined aquifer, the second part, the second types of the pumping well is the unconfined aquifer. So this is the setting up for the unconfined aquifer. So as you can see here, that for the unconfined aquifer, at the ground surface or at the first layer, you will directly identify that there is a aquifer layer. Okay, at the first layer, directly you will find that is the aquifer layer. So whether it's sand or gravel type of soil, alright. So it is a permeable layer. Alright, okay, so the rest of the parameter is same with the confined aquifer. So you also have the H0, you have the H1, you have the H2, you have the D1, D2, you also have the R1 and R2, and Q also D0. So here, again, remember that the H0 is located for the height of the layer from the groundwater table to the end of the aquifer layer. So this is an example of the exercise, and also the derivations for the unconfined aquifer. So if you can see here that the area where the flow will take place is a bit different with the confined. So at the confined layer just now, we need to consider at the aquifer layer, which is the thickness of the second layer is D. So for the unconfined aquifer, since at the first layer kita dah came across with the aquifer layer, so you have the 2πRH for the area, and then we use again the Darcy's law, and then we have the integrations of this equation. Alright, and at the end of the day you will have this equation. Alright, Q1 times R2 over R1 and divide by pi times with H2 square minus H1 square. So be careful, the power of 2 ni normally common mistake. Yeah? Student forget to put the power of 2. Okay, and this is an example. Eh? Alright, so how we solve for this kind of problem. So it mentioned that the well is sunk through a surface layer of loose sand. Alright, so there is no statement about there is a top layer above the sand and then overlay dan sebagainya. So this is the unconfined aquifer, right? Unconfined aquifer, and the water table was located at 2.5 meter, given also the D0 and D1 and D2. If there is no sketch provided, that means that you need to sketch the solutions. Alright, you cannot simply calculate because we need you to sketch the layout of the pumping well test. Alright, so be very careful when sketching the layout, then make sure that the observation well at the correct layer. So if it for the unconfined aquifer, there is no problem because you can freely put the observation layer since it's already in the aquifer layer. Alright, so just be very careful here. So H0 is again from the groundwater table to the end of the aquifer layer. So you need to calculate H1 and H2. Then once you have all the parameter, you can straight away use this equation. Alright, so you will have this value for this problem. Okay, just to show if it's for the confined aquifer, Okay, this is confined, alright. So this is confined because you have clay here and sand. Okay, so for the confined aquifer, when you want to sketch the schematic diagram, make sure that the observation well here, observation wells here, located in the sand layer. Maknanya dia mesti penetrate till the sand layer, because the aquifer layer is in here. The water is a lot in aquifer layer here. Alright, so it will have the drawdown from that aquifer layer. Alright, so this is also the common mistake. When you sketch the observation well, you sketch it is located here, which is it's actually at the impermeable layer, at the clay layer. So this is wrong. Okay, make sure that your observation well at least sunk into little bit into the aquifer layer in order to produce this drawdown. Alright, and this is the pumping well till the end of the aquifer layer. Alright, okay, thank you.